Hello, this is a short presentation on Cinegize. Cinegize, remote workstation graphics without compromise. I'll take you on a little quick journey to show you what you can do with Cinegize and what its unique features are. So, first of all, you need to get Cinegize. You can just download it from our website, click this button, and a couple of seconds later, the software is down and ready to install. Let's do that. Double click on the installer. And you now have these options. Install the main part, which is now highlighted, Cinegize KVM-over-IP. That's basically what we need right now. The other option, Cinegize Display Adapter, is if you want to install Cinegize as a service, for instance, for 24/7 unattended access on your machine at home, and you do not have a screen attached to it or inside a virtual machine or in a cloud instance where there's definitely no screen to attach to it either. Currently, we don't need that. We just want to use Cinegize to access other machines. So I'll press next. I get asked by Microsoft here whether I really want to do it. Sure, I want to do it. And we install the software. And we're done. That didn't really take that long. Now I can dispose of the installer and I can double click on the Cinegize icon here, and that invokes the connection client. Or there you go. I have used it in the past, so it has remembered previous connections that I have already established, save them along with password, because when you check this box here, as it says, save password when you check that box. But this panel here is actually the entire product, how Cinegize presents itself for starting a connection, but also for later on setting up this, for instance, an unattended service and to change the settings. To get to the settings of the package, you would go here. I just tell you that for completeness. But we don't need that at the moment. I just want to choose a machine that I have this already running on as a service, and I connect to that machine. In this case, the machine is called Cinegize 2 by pressing the connect button. Now it tries to establish a connection, which worked. It's waiting for the image, and there we go. Here is my first connection. Let me immediately turn the audio off. Great. So, what do we have here? This is a UHD connection to a machine here in the office, somewhere, I think it's one floor up. And that is running Cinegize as a service, unattended, so I can access this machine on the network whenever I want. This is just connected via a standard gigabit LAN connection at the moment. So you see some buttons here at the bottom. There is a settings button here. There is a indicator for a monitor. There's currently only one. If you had a multi-screen system, there would be multiple here. This is for extending to full screen mode. And here at the top, once you're in full screen mode, this is where the buttons are then hiding, and I can now leave full screen mode again. This is for sending something like Control Alt Delete. This is, as you've seen already, this is what I used to mute the audio. And here you have scaling buttons if you want to change the scale of what you're looking at. Good. Good, that's the first connection. I have two buttons that I have not further shown you. One of them here on the top, on the right bottom here, is the info button that tells you what currently the connection is looking like. We're using the H.265 codec. We are using full UHD at 420 color space at 8-bit. Frame rate currently is 26, 25, 26, and so on frames per second. If I move this around, which you can see quite quickly, I can show you that this is a very, very low latency connection. But how low it in fact is, here you can see the milliseconds. It takes 20, 25 milliseconds to encode this on the host side. The network latency is just a millisecond because we're on the local network. And locally here, the decoding takes another around 7 milliseconds to decode. Let's add this all up. Then we have here under 40 milliseconds in total latency end to end. That's roughly, if we look at the frame rate of the monitor being 60 frames per second, that's roughly 2.5 frames to get this transmitted. That is still quite nice to work with. Yeah, so that's really not, you're not suffering greatly. Even for games, this would be highly acceptable. Bitrate is currently at 5.5 megabit. If you look at the very bottom left here at this settings button, this gearbox here, or this little gear symbol, then you see this is how I can modify the current connection on the fly. Currently it's set to HEVC, 12 megabit. Yeah, and I have audio set to AAC at that bitrate. And currently this also defines what protocol I use. I have various protocols to choose from. SRT low latency is the default. We have UDP, we have SRT with a higher latency for more, say, noisy connections, RTC, that's quite useful sometimes if the other connections for some reason can't be established. That's set to connect to your host station. You do not normally require any changes to your network. You do not need to open any router ports or anything. This should cleanly punch through most firewalls. If not, then there is also a way to even make that happen by going by some reflecting service to make this still happen, and that should be a problem. But here, of course, my local area network, there is no problems with any of these. I'm just able to connect any of these machines. So one connection, mighty nice, but let's take this a little bit further. I am connecting to yet another machine. You've seen we have a pretty standard naming pattern here going on. And let's immediately also mute this. So here is my second connection. And now I can switch quickly between those connections. Yeah? So you see it's all instantaneous from one to the other. And let's add a third connection to this. I will add this station just as well. There we go, it's connecting. And here is yet another machine. Let's mute that as well. Good, so now I've got three connections. They're all on my local area network, but there are slight differences. This is the second one that I had opened before. Here, the connection is using the Daniel 2 codec. That's the one codec we developed, which is a iframe only, meaning every frame is sent at its whole. We're using a higher color fidelity. It's 4228-bit. And we have a lower latency to encode, and we have also a lower latency to decode. That means if you add this all up, I still end up being under 16 milliseconds latency. 16 milliseconds, that means that I have, basically one frame delay, not more, which is pretty much all you could ever expect to stay under one frame latency. Even if you connect your screen directly to your monitor, sometimes you have more latency than that. Depends on what post-processing, all that stuff actually happens in your screen. So one frame latency is pretty darn good. But you buy that by a much higher bitrate. On the local area network, that's not a big issue. Yeah, we have here currently, depending on what I do, if I move this picture around wildly and therefore, of course, create a higher refresh rate, I can top out even up to 300 megabit. But but you have a low latency, and you can choose different color formats as well that we have here. I can just quickly show that. Currently we can do 422, but you could even go to RGB, 444, and so on and so forth. So there are various higher fidelity color formats to choose from. This is, in this case, currently encoded on the host GPU and decoded here on the client using the host CPU. But you see, it is really not a problem to do any of that. Again, as I mentioned, we are still on the LAN. Now let's establish a connection to a machine that is actually on the internet. This is a machine that's on the internet. Actually, it's a machine that sits at my home. It takes a second longer to establish it. And here we go, yet another machine playing a variation of a Gangnam Style. If you hadn't noticed that, there's two times Gangnam Style playing here. And this is some David Guetta And here we have, yet one more K-pop clip. Memory lane. Anyway, this machine that I have sitting at home, which is basically technically more than 600, 700 miles away. Why? Because that's how far the signal travels. We have one internet provider here that connects to the main exchange, and then it goes from there back to the other internet provider, which I'm using at home. So total runtime therefore increases latency quite severely. What latency do we have? We have the encode latency in this case for HEVC is at around 28 milliseconds. That's already pretty high. But what really tops that is the runtime on the network, which is around 40 milliseconds, plus the decode latency. So we're hovering at around 70 to 80 milliseconds, which is still under the magic 100 millisecond latency, which some people say is basically the borderline where stuff becomes unacceptable. But with this, you can still, I can equally just drag this and play it, drag it around, and the latency is still very acceptable. You could even play some games here, or when you watch something like a video, then it really makes no big difference. But this still makes it suitable to use CAD CAM 3D packages, anything that requires faster response rates is still quite doable using this. Good, so you wonder, okay, he's got four connections going. That must be a pretty beefy machine on the receiving end to make this possible and to be able to handle all that stuff coming in and to decode it at the same time. So let's have a quick look at what machine I'm using here. I am using a Core i3-N305. That's basically, you would have said Celeron-style machine way back. So this is basically an absolute bargain basement, low-level, entry-level machine I'm using here. It has four cores and eight threads. And I bought it off the internet for $250 all in, with RAM, SSD, and so forth. But you see, it does a good job as a Cinegize client connecting to all of these machines. Currently, CPU load is under 40%, and also even the GPU, which is integrated in the CPU itself, is quite happy with this. Good. Why is this? Because we are actually cheating a little bit. You may think that despite the fact, because I can really change around wildly between all of these connections here, that they're all sending full blast at the same time, but that's not the case. The moment I switch to a different tab, the connection I'm not having at the forefront are basically more or less parked. And we can unpark them so quickly that this is, basically takes less than some milliseconds to get this whole going again. Therefore, we can keep the load on the receiving side quite low. But what happens if you want to see them in parallel? Well, you just grab the tab, you tear it off, and now we have both of these connections here visible at the same time. But that comes at a price, of course. Now you see the CPU load is much higher, the GPU load is much higher, because it needs to basically decode and render twice as much as before. But of course, if you have a much beefier machine than what I'm currently using here as a client, that is not an issue. You can, of course, then scale this much higher. As a reminder, this is still all connected via gigabit Ethernet. This here is via the internet. So the bandwidth on a normal connection or normal home network or even a corporate network, you shouldn't have any issues with any of this. So let's look at this session panel for once. This session panel is not just a session panel. If you look at all the details here, you see again, this is what you use to call up the settings menu. Here you can define the settings, the default settings, what you wish to use when you establish a connection to a host for the first time. Here, this is just for the user interface and whether you want to be prompted for admin permissions each time you do this, which then means you can also change other parameters that can only be changed by admins only. One of which is if you want to install Cinegize as an unattended service, you need to have admin rights. Currently, I don't because I just started the app without admin rights. That means I could now not install Cinegize as an unattended service. I would have had to start this app like here, run as administrator. Then if I had done that, then this wouldn't be grayed out and I could now install this locally also as an unattended service, allowing me to connect to this particular machine remotely. Well, that's it pretty much in a nutshell. Other features I still have in here, which I haven't mentioned. To allow public sharing, that means that it can be found by our lookup service, you need to press this button here. You would have to say enable public sharing, and then only then would, for instance, the unattended service allow you to do public sharing. It would still work on the internal network. You don't have to enable this if you, for instance, connect to Cinegize via VPN and you can resolve the machine name either just by IP address or by DNS lookup. But if you want this to be found by our lookup service, then you need to enable public sharing. And then we basically put the defined name into our lookup service and then this machine can be found and we know which IP address this leads to. And you could connect to it directly. If you are external and you know your own IP address, of course, you don't need this. You could just use your own home IP address and it would use the default port to connect to, which is this one here, the default port. And that would also work. But if you just really want to keep this on the down low and you want to just really just pass out that either automatically predefined name that we would give you here, or you have given your machine a specific name, then you need to enable the public sharing here so that it can be found by the internet lookup. What's the internet lookup? The internet lookup is this. If I basically define a name here that, or a randomly defined machine name that you could be given by the software, then here this at sign that you add behind it means look this name up on our lookup server, and then it tries to resolve that and find the IP address for it and establish a connection. Yeah, so in other words, it would take CineMuk N305. If I put that in here with an at sign behind it, it would look up our lookup server, resolve the IP address, and try to establish a connection. So much for that. I hope this was a quick overview that gave you a little bit of insight into what Cinegize can and can't do. Please feel free to use it. It is free. And if you have any feedback, just let us know. Thank you very much.